prize.
It's good to see you wearing this red shirt today. And inside your team, JD. I want to thank Tom Hoschild, I want to thank Gretchen, and everybody in this party, the Last County Democratic Party, for throwing this event. It means a lot to us as citizens of Valdosta. We can get together, like Tom said, and like-minded people to talk about ideas. I want to talk to you briefly about my candidacy for mayor. And some of the things that I want to talk about have already been mentioned. But one particular issue that I made part of my campaign platform when I did my campaign announcement on April 4th this year was public transportation. It seemed like for some reason that was never an issue until I announced my candidacy for mayor and made it an issue. And I want to talk, I want to just take out your cell phone for a moment and do a quick little workshop with me. I'm going to show you the money is there to pay for a public transportation system without even touching property tax. Just take your cell phone out, somebody who's real savvy with your cell phone. Go to your calculation app. Did you get there? All right, according to the 2010 U.S. Census, there are 57,000 people in Valdosta. Type in 57,000. Now, if only 2% of the population of Valdosta go on the bus, type in 57,000 times 0.02, 1140. That's 1,140 people riding the bus every day. Now type in 1.50, 1140 times 1.50. I'm just saying you'll charge $1.50 to ride a bus. Okay, now type in 365. 365 signifies the number of days the bus is going to run. 624,000. Hold that number in your head. Now, there are roughly 4,000 motel rooms in Valdosta. If you only occupy 50% of those and raise the hotel-motel tax one penny, type in 2,000. Now, the average hotel room is going to say costs $97 a night. So multiply 2,000 times 0.97. All right, multiply it times 365 days. You got $708,000 plus the $624,000 ridership that gives you, what, $1.3 million? Now, by us being a metro city, we'll help with federal funding, right? Up to $1 million. Give that $1 million federal funding plus that $1.3 million we raise locally, without touching property tax, we get $2.3 million that pays for our transportation system. Folks, the money is there. Don't let nobody say it's not there. The money is there. Now, we know we need a transportation system. We're the only metro city in Georgia without one. Macon, Rome, Athens, Columbus, Albany, even Hinesville, Georgia, have public transportation systems. Why can't Valdosta? We can do better, Valdosta. We must do better. Another platform issue I have is better paying jobs. I can't understand the average pay in Valdosta, Georgia is $935 an hour. That's a little less than $18,000 a year. Poverty is $25,000. One out of every three people you meet in Valdosta is living below the poverty level. One out of three. West Point, Georgia, for those of you who are not good at geography, it's a little small hamlet about the size of Hayhower between LaGrange and Columbus. 3,000 people convinced Kia Motor Company to build an assembly plant in their town. Hired 4,000 people. The starting pay at the bottom, $35,000 a year. Now, how many people in Valdosta, Georgia, can stand a pay raise from $18,000 to $35,000? Can you think that kind of pay raise? We can do better, Valdosta. We have got to go out there and encourage businesses. Valdosta is a jewel. It has a bush hiding in it. The world has discovered Valdosta. It's time for Valdosta to discover the world. We have got to step forward and become a leader in this state. That's why my motto is putting Valdosta first. It's not about about JD. This campaign is not about me. This campaign is about Valdosta, putting our city first, what we deserve to be. 20, 30 years ago in 1980, Valdosta was ranked number 7 in Georgia as for the top cities in the state. We're ranked number 14 now. What happened? We've lost the vision of Jimmy Rainwater. When Jimmy Rainwater was out there, he had a vision that we're going to have a convention in the center out here. Jimmy Rainwater said we're going to have high-rise hotels in Valdosta. Jimmy Rainwater said we're going to have good-paying jobs in Valdosta. We have lost that passion. We have lost that vision. I guarantee you, if you elect me as your next mayor, I'll work hard to bring Valdosta back to the way it right deserves to be as a jewel in Georgia. We have nothing to be ashamed of. We don't take a back seat to nobody. Nobody. Not Atlanta, not Savannah, not Columbus, not Macon, not anybody. This is Valdosta. This is Wintersville. It's time we take our rightful role in the state and let everybody know this is where you want to make your life. This is where you want to make your home. Valdosta, Georgia. My wife will tell you, when I got ready to retire from the fire department, I was offered jobs in other avenues, customers. I said, I am not leaving Valdosta. I raised my family here. I brought my mother to live here. My daughter who has multiple sclerosis, I got to take care of her here. I love this town. This town has been great to me. It has been a blessing for me to raise my kids the last 21 years in Valdosta, Georgia. I ain't moving. And while I'm here, it's all, it's the right thing for me to do, it's work. Do something for this city. Now, I know my time is running down, but we got to do something for our students to be issued. The flex card. Parents pay into that flex card. Right now, those students can only use that flex card for certain places to eat off of. Why can't we use the same concept that SCAD did in this matter? The School of Art was that design. The same thing that Georgia Southern did in Statesboro. Use that flex card. They go to the Office Max to buy school supplies. Go to the mall to buy clothes. Go to the car dealership, a car repair shop, get your car fixed. SCAD has 150 businesses in Savannah that accept SCAD one card. We can take that same concept and bring it back into Valdosta and make it work for our students. And give them a reason to shop downtown, to shop in that mall, once they ride that city bus. The Land Development Regulation, I know the verse really comes with the back of my hand, but the Land Development Regulation we have is a joke. It's easier to build a high-rise hotel building in downtown Atlanta than it is to open a restaurant in Valdosta, Georgia. It's ridiculous. Give you a classic example. In the LDR, it has a landscape ordinance. It says, if you're going to do a renovation project, you must provide landscape. But downtown, you have a zero property line. You step out your door downtown, go to the sidewalk. Where are you going to plant a tree at? Where are you going to plant a tree? It's no common sense to it. We got to use the common sense for those people. Let our business community know we want you in Valdosta. We're going to do everything we can to make your business profitable, because when you prosper as a businessman or a businesswoman, you're hiring people. At unemployment, we got 6.3%, which is higher than the state average, which is higher than the national average. It's going to come down. We're going to provide folks a job. Because you know what they're going to do? You're going to get up in the morning. You're going to get on that city bus. You're going to come to your job. They're going to put money in your pocket. They're going to make our economy grow. And Valdosta will prosper. I guarantee you that. Please, November 3rd, vote J.D. Rice. Put Valdosta.